Hi guys, welcome to Daily Technical Forex Forecast for the 10th of May. My name is Andrew Orshanetsky, I'm a technical analyst at TriumphFX. And traditionally we begin our forecast with the EURUSD. You see that the price continued falling and now it is testing the level of support, the technical level of support 1.0863. Moreover, this level is also a lower boundary of this global consolidation for the euro, and you see that this level was tested few times and it kept the price above it. If we take a look at our volumetric chart, you can see that pretty large accumulation of volume is concentrated in this consolidation, and you see that this level contained pretty huge volume after this gap. You can see it here. So the breakout of this level and the continuation of the fall will be a pretty interesting situation for opening short positions, because the price is going down this week, and really the confident breakout of this level will be a great situation, great signal that the price will continue its falling. Besides it, the price will exit this consolidation and this volume will be pushing the price lower, so all factors will be for opening short positions. So we can enter the market after a confident, a strong breakout of this level on increased volume, and after a small correction we open short positions and wait for further fall of the price. Stop loss should be set above the breakout volumetric bar, and our target is the level 0.730. So it's this level, so it's the lower boundary of this gap, so it's more than 130 pips, which makes this deal pretty profitable. So after the breakout of this support, short positions should be in priority for the euro. The pound. Unfortunately, the pound situation here is unclear. It's difficult to trade because we are trading in the consolidation. You see that volume is very, very low, so we are unable to highlight any volumetric zones or levels. Here you can see it in details. So really small volume. You see that nothing interesting here. So in such situation, it's very difficult to make some forecasts for the instrument. So I advise you just to skip the pound. Moreover, due to the absence of volume, it seems like big players are also staying out of the market now. So for the pound, well, the best decision is to stay out of the market and wait for the creation of some new volumetric levels or zones that can be used in trading. Our next instrument is the Japanese yen. As you can see from the chart, the price continued is growing. Yes, we have a correction, but if we take a closer look to our volumetric chart, you see that, well, this correction was on small volume, so it shouldn't be considered as a reversal signal for the yen. But unfortunately, as you can see from the chart, our support level is pretty far away from the current prices. Even this level that we planned to use as a stop loss is also far away, and unfortunately we don't have a good place for stop loss right now. So the best scenario for the yen will be a smooth correction of the price, then a creation of new support level. So this level should contain a pretty large volume, and then a strong rebound of the price from it and the continuation of the growth. So in such case we can open long positions. Stop loss should be set below this new fresh level of support, and the potential of the deal, the first target is the local maximum. If the price breaks this level, we should move our stop losses to the break even and wait for further growth of the price until the appearance of the reversal signal. But unfortunately from the current places there is no good deal for the yen. US dollar against the Canadian dollar, well, situation here remains the same. We are in small consolidation below the level of resistance 1.3785, and the situation, our previous scenario remains the same, so we should trade by the trend and we can reopen long positions only after a breakout of this level, confident strong breakout on increased volume, and after the fixation of the price above it, we open long positions and wait for further growth of the price. The stop loss should be set below the breakout volumetric bar, and the potential of the deal is around 90-100 pips. So short positions, and if we talk about short positions, really, I don't want to trade against such a strong uptrend. So only long positions, but after the breakout of the resistance. Our next instrument is the Australian dollar. Well, the situation here remains also the same. Yes, the price was fixed under this breakout under this breakout bar. So we saw a breakout of the local minimum, and you see that the price is trading below it. So it confirms our scenario for opening short position. So and we can enter the market after the resumption of the growth, especially if it will be if it be on increased volume. So in such case, we just open short position. Stop loss should be set above this level, this volume, this breakout bar. It's 0.7400, and the potential of the deal is around 70-80 pips. We need this confirming signal because confirming signal because we need to get an additional sign that bears are dominating the market, and they still have enough power to push the price lower, to push the price down. So after such a strong fall of the price on increased volume, we can open short positions for the Australian dollar. And our last instrument is gold. The price has already broken down its previous level of support, 1226.00, 1229.10, and we see a smooth correction of the price. This correction was on small volumes, so it shouldn't be considered as a reversal move. And our scenario remains the same. We should open short positions. If we take a closer look to our volumetric chart, you see that yes, this move was without volume, and this level of support, it's now acts as level of resistance because it contains really large volume, and it will be a good place for our stop losses when we open short positions. So we can enter the market after the resumption of the fall. So in such case, we open short positions. Stop loss should be set, as I told you before, above this level of resistance, and a potential of the deal is around 120-130 pips. And one more thing, this fall should be on increased volume, so situation is common to the Australian dollar situation. So we need the confirmating signal that bears still have enough power to push the price down, and if we get such a signal, we open short positions and wait for further fall of the price. If we take a closer look to the sentiment of the market, we can see that for the euro situation, the situation has changed. More traders, though, of course, more traders are still in short positions, but the tendency of traders to long positions is a good signal for our scenario of opening short positions for this instrument. For the pound, long positions should be in priority, but unfortunately, the price is trading in the consolidation. And all our other instruments, the yen, the Canadian and Australian dollars, and gold, are confirmed. So that's why we should watch for these scenarios for some additional signals and enter the market for this instrument. Overall, the best situation for the trading is for gold and for the euro. These two instruments are in priority today. If we talk about the yen, the Canadian dollar, and the Australian dollar, we can enter the market only after an appearance of confirming signals. So before that, we should stay out of the market. And For today it's all. Thank you guys for watching. Hope this forecast will be useful for you. See you tomorrow. Bye bye.